So hello everyone and welcome to the channel. This is the part 8 of the Unreal Engine beginner series, and in this video we're going to talk about lighting in Unreal Engine 4, the basic lighting in Unreal Engine 4. But before we do all of that, before we get into learning lighting, well, I would like you to say a happy new year. Yeah, it's a new year, it's 2022, as you can see right there, it's 2022. I hope you have a good year, I hope you have a very good 2022, and now let's get into learning lights. So in this video, I want to talk about the three light main light types: the directional light, the point light, and the spotlight. Direct light and the skylight, they are pretty advanced, and we are not going to cover them today, but we are going to cover them later. So firstly, let's actually talk about the directional light, which is already there in our scene. And I also made this quick little room. I know it's not the best thing in the world, but it's a room. And it's also open from one side as well. And this template is the time of the day template. Okay, so let's now firstly talk about the directional light. So I'll just disable all the walls right there and this floor. Okay, so the directional light, basically what it does is it actually simulates light which is coming from a source that's infinitely far away. So you can also see it right here. If you press Ctrl Alt, you can also see all the information about the directional light. Now the arrow on the directional light here, light right here, it actually tells you from where the light is coming. So in this case, it's coming from right there, right there. And you can see the sun there as well. You can press Ctrl L as the time of the day template. You can edit the sun's location. So we have the sun right there, and the arrow is pointing away from the sun. So as the light source is actually infinitely far away from the scene, it's really good for simulating the sun, because the shadows are parallel. And the parallel shadows, I mean, for example, let's take a cube, a sphere, and a cone, and maybe a cylinder. Let's take all of these. And let's actually move them a little bit up as well, the sphere as well. Alright, so as we can see, the shadows that are cast by all of these objects are going the same line, like they're going the same direction. That's what I mean by parallel shadows. So that actually represents the sun, right? The sun also casts parallel shadows, right? Just like that. So it's really good for simulating the sun. And it's also good for simulating the moon as well. Alright, so that's the directional light, about the directional light. Alright, so firstly, let's actually talk about all the settings right here in the light tab. So the light tab actually contains the settings that adjust the look of your light. The other things you can do are, for example, light shafts and light mask, but they are pretty advanced topics and we're not going to cover them today. So let's actually talk about the light tab first. So first setting, which is the most important setting, is the intensity. And yeah, you can already guess it, right? It's the intensity, basically. As you can see, 0 means, yeah, basically 0. And 10 is the default. And you can go all the way up to 150. And if you want to go higher than that, you can type in a number, for example, 1000. Yeah, that's a lot of intensity. Just like that. Now, the next important setting is the light color. Let's set to a bluish color, or maybe you can set to a reddish color, yellow. Let's set to blue color. Actually, looks really cool. Now, let's actually set it to back to default, which is white. The source angle is basically just the size of the sun right here. So, look at the sun, what happens to it, alright, when it changes. Yeah, it just got bigger, right? You can also enter any value, just like 10 maybe. Maybe even 50. Yeah, that's way too big actually. By default, it's 0.535700. The source of the angle, we're not going to talk about it right now. The temperature, we can enable this tick box right here and we can use temperature. So the lower the value this is, the warmer the scene is. The higher the value this is, the colder the scene is. So I'm going to show you right now what I mean. If I set it to lower values, as you can see, the scene gets warmer. You know, the vibe of the scene gets warmer. And if I set it to higher values, it gets bluish in color and gives colder vibes. So if I disable that, it goes back to default, which is 6500. And 6500 actually represents white color. Now effects was essentially the same as just hiding the direction light right here. It's basically the same thing. But if you hide the light right here and press the play button, then it does not stay like this and just enables when you play. But if we just enable it for a while, and if we disable this, then it's already disabled when you press play. So that's a major difference between them. Now the cast shadows, as the name implies, yeah, that's it. With the light cast shadows or not, that's it. That's the cast shadows toggle. And the volumetric scattering intensity finally is just used to, for volumetric light shafts actually. But we're not going to cover the volumetric scattering intensity right now. Okay, so that's the directional light. Let's talk about other light types as well. So if you go in a light style right here, and I'll just enable my room for a while, and the floor too. And I'm gonna delete all of these objects. Delete. And now let's actually grab in the most basic light right here, the point light. Now direction light is a global light. It's applied on basically everything. Every single object in your scene gets affected by the direction light. But the point light and the spotlight are local lights, and everything is not really affected by these lights. The area you want, they are only affected by these lights. So yeah, they're really useful if you want some local light, and if you want global light, then direction light. All right, so now that also has the intensity setting right here. It also has intensity. The light color, just like that. The attenuation radius is the radius of the light. If you set to lower values, you're gonna see a blue, the blue lines right here, the blue sphere. It actually shows you the area that the point light is affecting. So if I increase it, as you can see, it affects more area, and it affects less area right there. Alright, so the temperature is the same thing. This is colder and this is warmer. If I just set the default, this is warmer, this is colder. Effects world is just the same. Cast shadows is the same. And volumetric scattering intensity is the same thing. Alright, so that's the point light. Now let's talk about the spotlight. Now you may already have guessed that spotlight is light on a spot. So it actually casts light on this spot right here. If I increase the intensity, actually, as you can see, it casts light on a direct spot. You can also edit the inner cone angle and the outer cone angle. The inner cone angle is dark blue and the outer one is light blue. So it actually is to, you know, smoothen out or make it harder. As you can see, if they both are equal, then the edge is really hard. And if they're not equal and the inner cone angle is less, then it's smoothing out. You can also set it to zero, actually, just like that, to completely eliminate the inner cone angle. Alright, so the attenuation radius is the same thing. Just look at this, alright? Yeah, that's it. It's the distance that the spotlight is actually traveling, as you can see, just like that. Temperature is the same thing, less temperature, higher temperature. Light color is the same thing. Effects world is the same thing, and cast shadows also the same thing. The volumetric scattering intensity is also the same thing. Now you may also actually see this rec light right here. It was not really there in older versions of the Unreal Engine 4, but it's there now. And it actually, you can see that it casts light in a rectangle form. You can see it's just used to fade lighting. Actually, it's not really used to you know, it's not really used for a main light. It's just used to fake that light right there. But we're not going to talk about faking light right just yet. I'll delete that. So that was all about lighting in Unreal Engine 4. If you like the video, then do leave a like. And if you want to see more amazing content like this, subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys.